Hi friends, welcome to Linux Fork. My name is Chandan and today we are going to learn how we can restore a VM from backup. So in previous video I have shown how we can configure the VM backup on Azure Cloud. So you can go through my channel, you can learn about this, how we can configure the VM backup. Actually, in this video, I am going to show you how you can restore a VM from backup. Okay, so in previous video, I have configured backup for this VM. Okay, so when we go here in backup section, you can see we have the latest backup today morning. Okay, we have the backup of today morning. Okay, a snapshot and vault. So this is file system consistent. So we will restore from here. So how we can restore a VM? What are the prerequisite for this? Just I am going to explain in this video. So whenever you want to restore, first of all I want to explain why we are going for restore VM. So in most case what are the things we are facing and in which situation we are going to restore VM. So suppose you have deployed a application inside this VM, right? And you committed some changes on VM at 12 o'clock and you have the backup of 7:30 or 8 o'clock before at evening. Okay, and you made changes at 12 o'clock. So after changing that things, you are facing some issue. Okay, and you trying to troubleshoot that issue, what we made some mistake on that, and you can't able to find out that issue exactly what problem you have created when you are doing the something on that. Okay, suppose you committed your code and suddenly you facing some issue, your application is not running. Okay, you facing some module is not loading. Okay, you got that part. So in this situation, if you go for the troubleshoot, or if you are going to do the troubleshooting and resolving the issue, it will take if you are not aware what is the issue, then it will take a little bit more time, right? So it will take a little bit more time. So for saving this time, it is good idea either we can restore a VM from the backup and check our application is persistent or not, or we can create a new VM from restore. Okay, we have two options. Either we can replace that disk from the backup, okay, or we can create a new VM from the backup. We have two options. So currently I am going to show you how you can restore a VM from the backup. Okay, currently we are going to restore, means we are going to replace the OS disk of the VM. Okay, we are going to replace the disk of the VM from a snapshot. So let's start. Okay, just go to backup plate, click on backup. Okay, we can go for visiting here. We have two way. Either you can go to directly in recovery service vault, just search that recovery service vault. And then you select in which recovery service vault you have stored, taken the backup of the VM. Okay, just go to backup items. Select here a virtual Azure virtual machine, because here multiple types of backup. Okay, so we are going for the Azure virtual machine. Just click on here, then here you visited same place as we directly went from virtual machine. Just click on here, click on backup, and then we can, as you can see, we are here. So okay, so let's just start restoring the VM. So in this condition, we are assuming that we are not able to run our application here. Okay, that's why we are going to restore the VM. Okay, so just click on restore. Here they are asking restore point, so just select this. So latest one is this one. Okay, I have triggered this one manually, so I am selecting this 1252. Okay, just click here. Here they are giving two restore configuration. Either we can create a new VM from this backup, or we can replace existing one. So currently I am going to replace existing one. Okay, just I have chosen, and here they are taking temporary staging location. So this storage account you should have. If you don't find any storage account in your subscription, first create a storage account. Okay, and also remember one thing, I forgot to tell you, when you going to restore a VM, okay, VM should be in a stopped state. Okay, so so VM should be in a stopped state. I'm going to change here. I'm going to stop the VM first. VM is in a stopped state now. Now we can restore the disk. Okay, just go to backup, restore VM, select a restore point, click here, and replace existing, select a storage account here. This is temporary storage account. When they are going to replace the disk, that time this storage account they are using for processing the things. Okay, in backend, restore. Click on restore. So as you can see, triggering restore for VM demo backup. So restore is just started now. Okay, just click on here, and we can see restore, right? So one backup is also going on, and restore just now triggered. So you can see a progress here. Okay, okay, so it will take time. So actually it depends upon the size of your disk or disk size, and also how much data you have inside that disk. So it will take some time for replacing all the disk, all the data. Actually whatever the data is there, they are transferring all the component to existing one. It is overriding all the things, whatever the drive is there in backend. Okay, so I think it will take too much time, about 30 to 40 minutes it will take. and also it is depend upon your storage size inside the disk.
So friends, as we can see, transfer data from vault, it's completed. Okay, so data transferring it's completed. Now they are updating now the VM is updating according to our restore point. That is in progress. We will wait. We need to wait for some time. It will complete. So so as we can see, now it's showing completed. Okay, so now we can go to the VM. Okay, directly from here. Copy public IP and login using 40. Okay, now VM is running in a state, you can see here, right? Now we can log in to VM using 40. Okay, just for information, we are verifying it actually, either we are able to log in or not. Okay, so just select yes, give the username. So as we can see, I am able to log in the VM. Okay, so I think everything is working fine. There is no issue with the VM, and whatever the issue, it's replaced with our from the backup. Okay, so that's all in this video. Please subscribe my channel. I will create a similar video in future also, so I hope it will help you, and thank you for watching.